Welcome back at another video on digitalization of the model railway. In digitizing your railway, the important factor is train detection. If you want to control the train operation via a computer, then you need to know, or at least the program needs to know, where the trains are. And that is called block detection. So we need to detect the trains. Well, a very common and widely spread method of doing that is using current sensing, which means that if a train is in a block, it draws a current from the rails and that is detected. That works fine. That's why most people use it. It also looks good because you don't see anything on your track. The only drawback is that it is a little bit more expensive. And what I was trying to do is to use, let me zoom in a bit, to use the Arduino as digital interface for S8080 feedback of the detector signals, and also for DCC function and servo decoder. Why? Well, just because it's fun to do, and secondly because an Arduino is very cheap, only 3 to 4 euros, and that is of course always fun to see how you can do things on the cheap. So, in one of the previous videos, we already had a look at doing the train detection with an optical detector, and that worked fine. In this video, I'd like to go to the magnetic detection with a reed switch. You can see over here, if I zoom in on that a bit, you can see over here there's a reed switch. That is a small glass tube with a very sensitive metal switch inside that is operated by a magnet. Over here you also see a small round magnet. Well, this is not really a very small one. This is 12 millimeters. What I plan to use if I'm going to decide to go this way is to have a bit smaller ones of 8 millimeters. Is that expensive? Well, no. You can buy 200 pieces of those for 4 euros. So that is almost nothing per piece. And then the reed switch, is that expensive? No, also not. You can get those for, let's say, between 20 or 40 cents per piece. This one also is quite big. That's 2 centimeters, 20 millimeters. If you would like them to fit between, neatly fit them between the rail, it is possible to have a reed relay that is so tiny, that's only 10 millimeters long and also 2 millimeters wide, so it fits neatly between your rails. This one does not. This one I can show how it is mounted if there's enough light. Maybe I can zoom in a bit. This is mounted, as you can see, at the side of the rail. It's maybe barely visible, but it is here at the side. That's only because it is a little bit too big to fit between the rails. Well, let's have a look if it works. Let me zoom out a bit. Oh, let's first have a look at the magnet that is put, of course, under the train. I can probably show by just lifting this locomotive. If you can see it on the video, over here is the magnet just glued on there with a very tiny piece of sticky, double-sided sticky foam, and that is enough. Those magnets are so strong, even though the distance may be a bit much. Well, let me first put this train back on the rails. The distance may be a centimeter or more, but that's no problem because the magnets are so strong that they simply are able from that distance to operate that reed relay. There's a little blinking LED over here on the Arduino that blinks twice when the train is detected. Also, I have my multimeter attached that gives a beep. So let's run the let's go in the right direction. Let's run the train. Well, if you could hear that, there was a beep. There was even twice a beep. And also the blinking light on the Arduino could be seen. Yes, and let me do it again. Well, this means it works. Yeah, there's no problem in detecting this train. Why does it beep twice? Well, that's because there's one magnet, but the reed relay is sensitive in such a way that when the train passes over here, it it goes on. Then exactly in the middle, it goes off again. And then if the train is a little bit further away, it goes switches on a second time. I can probably show that by running very slowly. I'm going on speed step 1 now. Speed step 1. Well, it even operates the read switch 5 times, as you could hear. So that's funny. Is that a problem? No, not at all. Or also on S88, that's no problem. There's a sort of latch function that if there's a small pulse, it's already detected. So it's not a problem if you get 4, 5, or 6 pulses. Not at all. What happens if you run faster? Well, let me try to do that. I'm not able on this small short track to run very fast. Well, then you get only 1 beep. That's because the speed of the train is too much to trigger all the 6 of those beeps. Okay, so this works. What is the conclusion? Well, the wiring, of course, is little less than with the opto detector, because the opto detector needs 3 wires, 1 for the LED and 1 for the sensor, and then 2 for the power. But you can combine the ground wire, so you end up with 3 wires. This read relay only has 2 wires, one of which is the ground, so that can be a circular loop wire under your table, and then the other is the detection signal. So the wiring is 30% less than optical. It's exactly the same as when you would use current detection. I think I like it. I might decide to go for this, just because the wiring is simpler and the cost is very low, and it seems to work quite well. I've not made a definite conclusion yet, but maybe I'm going to try this on my more definitive layout. Well, thank you for watching, and see you back in a next video.